In this lecture, we will study about the magnetic elements. Magnetic elements are the physical quantities which describe completely in magnitude and direction the Earth magnetic field at a place. These quantities are magnetic declination, magnetic inclination, which is also known as dip angle, and the horizontal component. Magnetic declination is represented by theta, magnetic inclination is represented by delta, horizontal component represented by H. Now let us study these components one by one. First is magnetic declination or angle of declination. Magnetic declination is the angle between the magnetic meridian and the geographic meridian. As you know that the magnetic meridian or the geographic meridians are the vertical plane. The vertical plane passes through the geographic axis is called geographic meridian, and the vertical plane passes through the magnetic axis is called magnetic meridian. And the angle between these two is called angle of declination. Angle of declination is not constant for the Earth. Its value varies from place to place. The lines which are joining the points of the same angle of declination are called isogonic lines. And the lines which joining the points of the zero declination on a map are called agonic lines. Angle of declination is measured with the help of magnetic compass. Now, if it is a geographical north and it is a magnetic north, then this angle is the angle of declination. Next is dip or the angle of inclination or magnetic inclination. This angle, which is a resultant direction of the resultant intensity of the Earth's magnetic field, makes with the horizontal line in the magnetic meridian is called dip angle or inclination angle. So, what is the dip angle? Angle between the horizontal line in magnetic meridian and the Earth's resultant magnetic field at a place. Angle between horizontal line and the direction of the resultant intensity in magnetic meridian is called angle of dip, angle of inclination, or magnetic inclination. Value of the magnetic inclination is 0 at equator and is 90 degree at poles. The lines joining the points of the same value of the dip are called isoclinic lines. The lines joining the points of the zero dip angle on a map are called aclinic lines. The dip circle is used to measure the angle of dip. It is a diagram of the dip circle, and this dip circle is used to measure the angle of dip. It is a magnet, and these are the graduations, and this magnet is free to rotate on a vertical plane. This angle is the angle of dip. Now at equator, this will be the position of the magnetic needle, so the angle is 0. At poles, the position of the needle is like this, so this angle is 90 degree. Third magnetic element is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. The horizontal component of the Earth's magnetic field is the component of the Earth's magnetic field in horizontal direction. That is BH equals to B cos delta. Similarly, the vertical component is BB equals to B sin delta. Now, it is a magnetic meridian, this is a geographic meridian, this angle is angle of declination, This angle is angle of inclination or the dip. Now when we draw the horizontal component, we resolve the magnetic field along the horizontal component and the vertical component. This component is the horizontal component of the Earth's magnetic field, and its value is B cos delta. Similarly, the vertical component is this one, and its value is B sin delta. If we square and add these two quantities, then it will become BH square plus BV square equals to B square cos square delta plus B square sin square delta. Taking B square common, it becomes cos square delta plus sin square delta, and so it is equal to B square. Or you can say B is equal to under root of BH square plus BV square. If we divide these two equations, that is, if it is written as BV upon BH, then it is equal to B sin delta upon B cos delta, which is equal to tan delta. With the help of this four equations, all types of the numericals of this topic can be solved. Now let us see a numerical. In the magnetic meridian of a certain place, the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is 0.26 gauss. Now what is given here? The horizontal component, which is written as B cos delta, and it is equal to 0.26 gauss. Gauss is a unit of magnetic field in CGS system. We have to find out B, and the angle of dip is 60 degree. The value of the cos 60 degree is 1 by 2. So it is 0.26, and B is equal to 0.52 gauss.